Hey, Mini Fash. It's the 15th day of December. This has to be brought out. I can't help it. I see just article after article after article of the Sandy Hook 7-year anniversary, remembering the victims. Okay? Now, I'm not going to go through this whole thing because people should know by now that there are so many things wrong with this story. It's got more holes in it than the Swissiest Swiss cheese. You understand? This is just illustrating to you the depth of evil that men will go to serve this world, to serve mammon. It's just beyond measure, okay? You gotta understand this stuff, that this event alone, exploiting the death of children like they did, it has grown to a point where they're actually allowing, these are judges, okay, that are allowing these fake victims, the fake families of the fake victims of this incident, to sue firearms manufacturers. Think about that. That's like if you go and buy a Ford and run your neighbor over with it, their family can sue Ford. Do you understand? This is the level, not just of evil, but insanity we're dealing with. We could go through the same series of hole after hole after hole in this story, right? Not one medevac helicopter was dispatched. Not one! You can't dismiss this stuff. You can't. You simply can't. No crime scene photos or videos. None. No bodies. None. They immediately demolish and dispose of the school, just like they did 9/11, right? The one thing I want to leave you with in this little brief little diatribe here is the fact that on the day of this incident, the very day, the firehouse somehow had already had delivered Christmas trees. Of course, to memorialize all the poor victims and keep the people in a state of emotional despair. Because that's where the devil wants to keep you, in fear, doubt, and insecurity, so that you will just simply die in your sin and be thrown into the pit. I don't know how else to put it. This was a lie. People have pointed this out and suffered greatly for it. Because they know if this comes out, the truth of this, that the feds, the state, the local, all that were involved in this giant lie? Oh boy. But the fact of the matter is it was a lie. And the only reason I'm pointing this out to you is because it's not gonna stop. And it goes far deeper than men seeking wealth and power. It is a spiritual war for your very soul. You need to approach these things in that manner. Or you will suffer the consequences, just like all these people who perpetrated this gigantic lie. State police, the coroner, all of them, folks, all of them. This guy here coaching the coroner, the crazy nutbag coroner, the bazillion holes in this whole thing, the lying parents, the liars and deceivers left and right. 90-pound kid did all this. Not one single medevac shows up. This is insanity, but it's right in front of your face, folks. And it's the kind of thing we need to face. We have to face it. So, I mean, I just had to put this out. Because it's a lie. A lie is a lie and truth is truth. Somebody needs to ask them how they knew to have 26 Christmas trees ready before this incident even took place. Answer me that riddle, Batman. This kind of stuff just ticks me off. But vengeance is the Lord's. So pray for these people while they still have a chance. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord, and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armour of God,